Good morning, students. In yesterday's class, I discussed the meaning of capital receipts and I discussed the meaning of revenue receipts. And there, I told you the features of revenue receipts and the features of capital receipts. And I have given you certain examples of revenue receipts and certain examples of capital receipts. And there I told you that if you remember these features and if you know the meaning, the features what I told you in yesterday's class, the same features I have written in today's class also. From the basis of these features, in today's class, I am going to differentiate between capital expenditure and the revenue expenditure. And whenever you are going to write the differences, beta, you have to write in the tabular form. One side you write on the basis of what you are going to differentiate them. Alright, this is unknown to you. And yesterday I told you, these are the features in yesterday's class I discussed. And I told you, remember these features. And if you know the features, easily you can differentiate them. So today's class, I am only going to discuss the difference between capital receipts and the revenue receipts. First, on the basis. First, you write meaning. Meaning of capital receipts, meaning of revenue receipts. What is capital receipts? Capital receipts are those receipts which are not basically taken place in the normal course of a business firm. These kinds of receipts are taken place once or twice in the lifetime of that particular business firms. Yes or no? Now on the other hand, what is revenue receipts? Revenue receipts are those receipts which basically the firm received on the normal course of their work. They basically received in very frequently on the day-to-day basis. So this kind of receipts are called revenue receipts. Now point number two, nature. Capital receipts are non-recurring in nature. You know what do you mean by the non-recurring in nature? Which is not taking place very frequently daily. So, second point, nature. So, you write here, capital receipts are non-recurring in nature. On the other hand, revenue receipts are recurring in nature. Why recurring? Because this is taking place very frequently a normal course of the business. Third point, you write here, shows. Point, next slide. Capital receipts is basically shows. In the liability side of the balance sheet, on the other hand, revenue receipts are shown in the credit side of the profit and loss account. Yes or no? Next, you can write here the examples of the capital receipts. You can see so many examples are given there. Easily you can write the examples. One more very important point I forgot to tell you. Capital receipts creation. You write here next point. Creation. Capital receipts creates the liabilities of the organizations. On the other hand, revenue receipts create the income of the organizations. So first point, meaning. You write the meaning of capital receipts, you write the meaning of the revenue receipts. Second, write the nature. One is non-recurring in nature, the other is recurring in nature. Now it is shown in the account side. You can write here, capital receipts shown in the liabilities of the balance sheet. On the other hand, revenue receipts shows in the credit side of the profit and loss account. Next, I told you creation. Next point, creation. Point of receipt, creation. Capital receipts creates the liabilities to the firm. On the other hand, revenue receipts create the income of the firm. And next, definitely you can write the example. So, 4 to 5 points. Easily you can write better. So I told you again, if you know the meaning, if you know the characteristics, easily you will be able to write the differences also. So I am not going to teach you anything more in today's class, because from this chapter only these things are there. Meaning of capital expenditure, meaning of revenue expenditure. And always you remember the features of revenue expenditure or characteristics of revenue expenditure and the characteristics of capital expenditure. And if you know the characteristics, easily you can differentiate, my dear son. Same way, In, I told you what is the meaning of capital receipts, what is the meaning of revenue receipts. And then I told you the other day's class, the characteristics of revenue receipts and the characteristics of capital receipts. And if you know the characteristics, easily you can differentiate them. So I told you the show, you have to learn the meaning and difference. Just one more little bit things are there to be taught from this chapter. That is the meaning of defrayed revenue expenditure. It will take 3 to 4, maximum 2 to 3 minutes. And that's I am not going to teach you in today's class. In tomorrow's class, I'll discuss this and then I'll finish this particular chapter. Next day's class, I'll discuss about the meaning of defrayed revenue expenditure. And if you can ask me, sir, what of that I'll discuss, what of the question answer you are supposed to learn in from this particular chapter, what is from the syllabus, I'll discuss in the next day's class. So today, I just told you the difference here between or difference between capital receipts and revenue receipts. And there I told you how to write it. You always remember the characteristics better. Difference learn karne ka koi zarurat nahi hai. If you know the characteristics, easily you can differentiate them and you know how to write the differences. I hope it is clear to you. So next day's class, I'll take 3 to 4 minutes to finish off these particular chapters. So thank you. Thank you so much for today's class.